Today, I'm going to be talking about the helmet of salvation, and you don't want to miss it, so please join me. Welcome to The Bold Encourager. I'm Rebecca. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you're new to my channel, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. It doesn't cost you anything. It just allows for me to get my faithful, encouraging messages out to everyone. So today we are learning about the helmet of salvation, and we're almost done. We have two more episodes of the spiritual warfare, and then we'll be going on to a new topic. But today we're talking about the helmet of salvation. So the verse comes from Ephesians 6:17. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. What we need to realize is that the helmet is what protects our minds. And so that's why this particular armor, just like any other part of the armor, is very important. So let's read Isaiah 59:17. Where it actually talks about Jesus wearing this part of the armor. He put on righteousness as a breastplate and helmet of salvation on his head. He put on garments of vengeance for clothing and wrapped himself in zeal as a cloak. Isaiah is talking about the coming of when Jesus would come. And he wore the helmet of salvation. And we want to be like Jesus, right? So we want to protect our minds and remember that the enemy is going to attack our minds. It is a battlefield. So what he tries to do is he tries to corrupt our minds by tempting us to watch things we shouldn't watch, listen to things we shouldn't listen to, and then also open ourselves up to things we shouldn't as well that aren't from God. He may try to make it like it's nothing. Oh, it's no biggie. You can watch that, or you can do this, or you can do that. But what the enemy does is he tries to make it very subtle and make it where it's not a big deal when it really is. Because all it takes is that one little, you know, no, it's not that bad. And then your mind is affected. It starts to get corrupted because once you allow things in, it starts to also corrupt your heart. And you want to keep a pure heart so that you can be righteous and living the life that Christ wanted you to have. That's why we've been saved, right? That's what salvation is about. You know, the enemy is going to attack your mind with discouragement as well. So when you feel discouraged, you feel like there's no hope, just remember that that's what the enemy does. He wants you to think that there's no reason to do something or have no hope and give up and not try harder. So you got to remember that the enemy is going to do anything he can to discourage you. By the way, these notes I got from the Blue Letter Bible. Chuck Smith was the one I used this time, and I will link that down below. So there's three categories that salvation is separated into. Justification, because it means we're saved from the penalty of sin. Sanctification, because we are saved from the power of sin. Glorification, because we are saved from the presence of sin. And the helmet is all three of these characteristics, which is the hope of salvation. So the helmet that we wear daily, which is the helmet of salvation, is actually the hope of salvation. That's what gives us hope, what keeps us not discouraged, encourages us to keep going. So we're going to read some verses where this correlates with how important your mind is and why the mind is a battlefield and why we got to keep it in a good place. So let's read 1 Thessalonians 5:8. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober, having putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. See right there? It's the hope of salvation. We need to be sober-minded to protect our minds from the evil one. He's looking for us to trip up. He's waiting for us to mess up. So when we're not sober-minded, it's not good. I'm not going to say it's terrible to drink because, you know, I don't think that it's bad to have one or two glasses of wine. But I think what it is that makes it a problem is if you go beyond that where you're not sober-minded. If you are just doing it to socialize and relax and not to get drunk, you're fine. But when you start to use it to get drunk, then the enemy has the ability to come in and sway you when you're not sober-minded. So just remember, yes, it's fun in the moment, but it's not good for you, because when you're trying to live a righteous life, you're not going to be able to combat the enemy because he's got you in the position he wants you to be in. So be careful with those things and remember why the enemy is always looking for a chance. Romans 8:6, for to set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the spirit is life and peace. So let your mind be controlled by the spirit instead of the flesh. A lot of times it's the opposite. We let the flesh control our minds and we don't let the spirit be in charge. The spirit is what you want in charge, because your mind, when controlled by the spirit, is going to do the right thing. It's going to follow what's wise. So let it be controlled by the spirit and surrender to Christ, because it's going to make your life that much better and you're going to be closer to God that way. So Philippians 4:7, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. So the helmet of salvation will guard our minds with peace that comes from God. That's Jesus. So when we're like utilizing the helmet of salvation, our minds are at peace. We're not feeling troubled. We're not feeling like, even when things could be going wrong, you feel at peace because Christ is there and he is guarding your heart and your mind. So let us guard our hearts and our minds and let us be aligned with Christ. Psalms 26:2, prove me, O Lord, and try me. Test my heart and my mind. So we need to be more like David. David wrote a lot of Psalms. But one thing that we can see is that David had this heart for God. And so he wanted God to test his heart. He wanted him to have his mind tested as well. Because our mind and our heart are connected. Whatever in our heart comes out of the mouth. So whatever is in our mind comes down to the heart and out of our mouth. When you're not pure of heart, you tend to say or think things that aren't right, that are just not, that can become selfish or not of God. And so the thing that we want is God to test those things, test our heart, test our minds, because we want to be pure in our mind and our hearts. And it's not at any means that I know I am not completely pure in the mind or the heart all the time. I try to be, but I do have a heart for God like David did. And so I think that the most important thing to note is that we're not all going to be in 100% purified in the heart and the mind at all times. But that is what the helmet of salvation for the head is supposed to be for, and the breastplate of righteousness is for, to protect your heart. So when we're guarding ourselves, we may slip up here and there. That's going to happen. We're not perfect, but we can try everything we got to really live out our lives being protected by the spiritual armor, so that we do keep ourselves guarded and we do keep ourselves ready to stand strong against the enemy, because our mind is a battlefield. And so I'm going to ask you, are you protecting your mind diligently? Because this is war. We're in a battle right now. We always are going to be. It doesn't change. It's not going to get any different. We're going to be fighting for Christ. And it means let's get protected. Let's protect our minds. Let's do what we need to do. So I really want you to think of things that you can eliminate out of your life that might not be good for you to watch or listen to or even, you know, be a part of. I mean, maybe there's something, you know, you kind of feel the Holy Spirit like giving you that nudge, that conviction, like, don't do that. And maybe you need to just start to really hear what he's trying to tell you and make that happen, because we need to all be firm and in place and ready to really spread the word of God. And we got to be protecting ourselves, because he's going to try to take us out while we're doing that. So let's close out in prayer. Thank you, dear Lord Father, for this message. I pray that we protect our minds and be the kind of individuals that really go and guard our hearts and our minds, Lord Father. I pray that we are not susceptible to the enemy, that we remain sober-minded, that we do what we need to do to live a life that is representative of you, that we will go about and spread the word of God and be very vibrant about our salvation stories. And let's just learn how to protect our minds to where the enemy can't discourage us from doing what you've called us to do. May we be warriors that stand firm on the grounds of what you've done for us. And may we never stop, Lord Father. Keep us all protected, our families protected, our friends protected. And may many people we know and meet be saved. In Jesus' name, please present those opportunities for us. May we be so bold to share the gospel and be full about it and be passionate about getting people saved. And I thank you for these things in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Well, I hope you enjoyed this message. And if you did, please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't followed me on social media, what are you doing? Please follow me on social media. The links will be down below. And every Wednesday at 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, I'm going to post a new faith-based message, and you don't want to miss it, so go ahead and hit that notification bell. Well, I hope you have an amazing day, and I hope you stay encouraged.